In this video, I will talk about what is a soprano two or a mezzo, what is the range of a mezzo singer, who are examples of mezzo singers, and how to work out if you are indeed a mezzo or soprano two. If you aren't sure what a vocal range is, make sure that you check out this video above, which gives you a little breakdown summary of what that terminology means. The Italian word mezzo means half, middle, or medium, which makes it a perfect word to use when referring to singers who sing in the middle. One thing that gets a little confusing is the term mezzo sometimes in choirs is referred to as soprano two. Typically, the mezzo does sing quite high and it can double up with the melody with the soprano one line, but we do call them a soprano two or a mezzo. And when I refer to one or the other, I mean the same thing. Nowadays, we recognize that a mezzo singer has a range between an F3 and a B5. But you have to be careful not to confuse a mezzo or a soprano two with a belter. A belter is a different vocal type, but you can have two together. You can have a mezzo belter. The term belter is typically used in musical theater or sometimes contemporary singing. What is tricky is the mezzo or soprano two part can be a little tricky to identify when you're singing in a choir. It is very rare that a mezzo should have their own vocal line. Typically, they share it with the soprano ones. When you look at a score, you typically look at the top line where the soprano ones are singing. Pay close attention to that line. Are their stems going both up and down? Does the score indicate soprano one and soprano two, indicating that the mezzos are singing there? When a score has only one note, but the soprano ones and twos are meant to be singing it, that means that the soprano one and two are singing in unison. However, you will notice as well that sometimes there are two notes visible. You will always follow the lower note if you are a mezzo. And sometimes this can be indicated with a stem down, but not always. So how do you find out if you're a mezzo singer? The first thing that you would want to do is make sure that you sit down with a piano app, or an instrument that you feel comfortable with that is not a wind instrument, and go through your range slowly. How high can you sing and how low can you sing? If you don't have a piano available, I always just use a little keyboard app and it always has the notes visible here. So I know that the F3 is my lowest note, ma, and I would sing slowly up the scale. Actually, I would do the half steps as well. Ma 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 ma, and I would go through slowly, not as quickly as that, and I would go all the way up to my B5 note. You possibly won't have the entire range of a mezzo, perhaps you can't sing as high or as low, but if you sing it generally in that range, then you probably are a mezzo singer. And if that seems a little bit too tricky for you, you could always sing along with any singer that identifies as a mezzo singer. Ranges are always unique and the singing voice is a instrument unto itself. Trained singers might be able to sing higher or lower than the traditional ranges that I have shown you today. However, they might identify still with that range. Off the top of my head, a few contemporary singers which I would identify as mezzos would be Sarah Bareilles, Madonna, and Adele, although Adele is a belter, which I will make another video on explaining what that means. And in musical theater, I would look at Miss Adelaide from Guys and Dolls, Grisabella from Cats, and Epony from Les Miserables as examples which you might want to sing along with. I've left these in the description below for you to check out and have a listen to so you can get an idea about where the mezzo voice sits. And that's it from me. Are you a mezzo singer? You decide. If you have any questions, please leave them in the details below. And until then, happy singing.
If you enjoyed this video and want access to more free warm-ups, meditations, and other singing-related videos, make sure you subscribe. I am a new channel and any support is appreciated so I can make more material for you guys. Anyway, that's it from me. See you next time.